note down linear property, scaling property, shifting property, multiplication by t raised to n, and this is division by t. Is it clear? So I think five properties from this five, definitely three properties will come, and moreover I have seen multiplication and division tricks, one question is there. So you can see here what this property says, students. Yes, it says that if you take the Laplace transform of f of t divided by t is equal to integration from s to infinity f of s, this is capital F of s ds. So this can be proved by using the definition which we know from the Laplace transform. And please remember, f of s is nothing but integration 0 to infinity e raised to minus st ft dt. This is the definition of Laplace transform. Okay, so this one can easily prove this, but again you may get confused, so we will not take this. Can be proved by definition of Laplace transform. I think you have seen Laplace transform definition, students. This is Laplace transform definition. Yes, that f of t be a function of t defined for all positive values of t, then you can see the Laplace transform of f of t is denoted by L of f of t, which is defined as L of f of t is equal to integral 0 to infinity e raised to minus st f t dt. Is it clear? So by using this definition, one can easily find L of f of t divided by t is equal to integration s to infinity, this is capital F of s ds by definition of Laplace transform. Okay, so here as yes beta,
so all this you have to write in the book.
Yes, you have to write it, and when you come offline I will check one by one, so that any mistakes are there you can solve it right now. So some of your friends, they don't write it, but see that you practice for your exam purpose. As you are grown up, so you should do it very easily, but still I put effort and I check the fair book. Whoever gets complete, please show me the fair book, I will correct it, and I see the mistakes. So the same mistakes you should not repeat in your final exam. That is very, very important. So you should not make mistakes.
Okay,
that is
sir.
What students must do it. Okay, so this is for everyone, right? So now you can see, as your friend says, ask me that, sir, which formula are going to study, which formula is important, that I am already noted down here. So you can see the first formula, this is integration of f dash of x divided by f of x dx is equal to log of f of x. I think this formula you have come across. Yes, this is already in the integration. You have to search again, it will take time. So directly I have written the formula list only. So second formula, integration 1 upon x square plus 1, you can see this is tan inverse x. Definitely plus c is there, constant, it is not required, because all here we are going to take it is definite integrals, so there will be no plus c, that is constant is not required, so I have not written. And next we have log 1, you can just check, it is 0. And also I think everybody knows that one, if you divide this by infinitely, yes students, it will tend to 0. This is tend to 0, not equal to 0, it is tending towards 0, means how many times you can divide 1, it is infinitely we are going to divide. So definitely this all formulas we are going to use in this property. So now see which property this is. Immediately you can understand which property you are going to use. So I will tell you that trick also. Then you can see your question. Find the Laplace transform of the following. Is it clear, students? Now you can see e raised to minus at minus e raised to minus bt divided by t. So wherever there is divided by t, keep in your mind, immediately it should strike in your mind that this is division property. Division property, which formula I'm going to use? Laplace f of t divided by t is equal to integration s to infinity f of s ds. So again and again I'm repeating the formulas. some students will get bored, but I repeat this formula again and again because it should be fixed in your mind. When I ask what is division of t property, you have to tell me L of f of t divided by t is equal to integration s to infinity capital s ds. So remember this for property, and by using this some of the important formulas, so you are going to solve this problems. So what we have, the example we have taken, find, see, simple question they will ask, find Laplace transform, that's it. So you will get 20 to 25 marks on the Laplace transform. So you can see it may be multiplication, it may be division, it may be shifting property, it may be linear property, it may be scaling property, right? So all properties you must be perfect. And the first example you can see here, a, which is given e raised to minus at minus e raised to minus bt divided by t. Is it clear? This question they have given. Okay, sorry. Okay, now you can see here, very simple. Okay, find the Laplace transform of the following they have given. Okay, so let us see one example you try to understand. Definitely you can see here, friends, easily all examples you can simplify. So I will go very slow now. As I have told you that you should know the first all the formulas at least. See, it is difficult to remember the formula, but I also tell you the trick how to remember the formula. Similar type of formulas you have to repeat and practice at a time. Okay, at least my suggestion for especially for diploma students is at least you practice 4 to 5 times formula. Yes, friend, this is a request for everyone that without seeing, again, don't copy it same as it is. Without seeing, you write it down formulas. I already told you before going to your bed or before going to the sleep, at least take 5 minutes, not more, 5 to 10 minutes. Whatever formula I'm going to use in this class, just before going to bed, 10 minutes you spend, write down the formulas in the first page. I already told you, every class I'm going to give some formula and properties, right, students? So this formula, before going to bed, just write it down in the first page. And then write it down once again in the example also. So I think 2 times it will be practiced. Means remaining another 2 times, what you do? You make a separate page, right, and write down all the formulas till today, how many formulas are there. So you just write it down, keep it ready. If your formula list is ready, you can post to me or you can WhatsApp me. I will go through, see why I'm checking this formulas is some of them, what they will do in hurry or in busy time, they will write down the wrong formula. So this must not happen. So I'm taking lot of care. See that you also put the efforts, right, students? Okay.
Yeah, so, thank you, sir.
Yes, thank you, beta. So first example, we let us see how to solve this problem. Very, very important. Very simple tricks I will tell you. First, you should know which formula is this, e raised to minus 18. I think you remember the formula, right? So I will just write here once again, which formula you're going to write. See, at least if you write formula, you will definitely get 1 or 2 marks. So in the beginning, so first I will take this e raised to 18. Yes, can anybody tell me what is the formula for e raised to 18?
1 upon s minus a.
Yes,
1 upon s minus a.
Yes, minus a. Very good. This is how you have to be perfect, students. Everyone must be. When I ask immediately formula, you should be able to tell me at a time. Now, see, here it is, minus a is there. Means you must understand this. Again, don't by heart this formula, e raised to minus a t. If it is e raised to minus a t, what will become? 1 upon s plus a. Is it clear? Because a I have substituted minus a, minus into minus will become plus. So no need of again by heart this formula. Only by heart this first formula, you should understand what is the Next formula. So similarly, if we have Laplace transform of e raised to minus bt. So can anybody tell me what will be the formula?
1 upon s plus b.
Yes, very good. Excellent. You are correct, beta. So like this, what I tell everyone is at least Bahat this first formula, second and this third, immediately it will strike in your mind. Is it clear? Okay, so let us
start. Sir?
Yes, beta.
So one of my friend Rahul Patil is unable to join, so please let him in.
Okay, no problem. Is he there? Yes, he is admitted now. I think yes. So Rahul Patil is there? Yes. Okay, so what I have to do here, see, here you can see clearly mentioned, we have to first find out f of s. So what is this f of s? You know already, to find f of s means I have to find Laplace transform of e raised to minus at minus e raised to minus bt. Either you can simplify like this, or at a time you can simplify. Let us not get waste our time. So I will take divided by t also. So you should be careful, students. Only 2-3 steps you can see you are going to apply the Laplace, right? So okay, so first what will be the, this will be equal to, it is equal to integration s to infinity. Looking at it is divided by t, we are going to use the division by t property. So integration s to infinity f of s, l of f of s. F of s is nothing but l of f of t. Therefore, I will take this in bracket, l of e raised to minus at minus l of e raised to minus bt. And this is ds. Just I have substituted the values. Please, if you don't understand, please tell me, beta.
Sir, f of t equal to f of s only, no, sir?
Yes, you are right. See, L of f of t is nothing but f of s. Any doubt? Please remember this, friends. In the beginning of the class, I have told you, L of f of t is nothing but f of s. So L of f of t I am going to do. So this is L of f of t. Yes, students, any doubt? Because this is the first step, very, very important. Shall I repeat once again? Okay.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes, beta.
You have to take the Laplace individually, right?
Right, you are right. So here see, this t will be substituted as, divided by t will become integration, and f of t will become, l of f of t will become f of s. Is it clear? Understand the property first, then you can simplify here. So this t will go, divided by t will go, and it will become integration s to infinity, and this l of f of t will become l of e raised to minus at minus e raised to minus bt. Okay, we'll take another 2 steps more. Okay, ds. So this is our f of s. Please remember this, one. This is f of s. L of f of t is nothing but f of s, means function of s. Function of t will be there. This is going to Laplace transform of function of s. S is a parameter. Please remember the students. Okay, so this will become f of s. Now we'll simplify. I cannot put directly the integration, therefore I will keep integration infinity s to infinity. First I will write down what is Laplace of e raised to minus at. Laplace of e raised to minus at already I have written, so I will just simplify here. 1 upon s plus a. Okay, minus I will keep it as it is, minus I will keep it as it is. Then Laplace of e raised to minus bt you already written here, so I'll just simplify this. 1 upon s plus b, and this is ds. So this I have substituted. Laplace transform I have done here, okay, because this is in the standard form, that is e raised to minus at and e raised to minus bt, it is in the standard form terms. Okay, so now next step. So as I have told you, yes, what we have, I am going to use this property. Where is that property? Yes, so integration of f dash of x divided by f of x dx is equal to log f of x. This formula I am going to use. So here you can see, I will show you one, next you will immediately understand. See here, so this is integration. Now I will take f of x as s plus a. Okay, so you can see, means I have to do,
excuse me sir.
Yes, beta.
Sir, can you repeat this step again?
Okay. Yes. Now see here. See. This property you have understood? When
yes,
it
sir.
Is divided by t, you will use integration.
Yes, sir.
Okay. And this f of t. So this is your L of,
excuse me, sir.
F of t will become f of s. Yes, beta?
Okay, sir.
It will become f of s. F of s is what? L of f of t. So what
yes,
I have done? L of e raised to minus at minus e raised to minus bt I have took. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Integration will be divided by t. So divided by t will go away. Okay, now we will go for one by one Laplace transform. In this Laplace transform, you can see this is in the standard form, that is e raised to minus at is in the standard form. Therefore, we have already solved this e raised to Laplace transform of e raised to minus at and Laplace transform of e raised to minus bt already solved. So this
yes,
two formulas I will substitute in this equation. So
okay, sir.
Yes, sir.
Integration. Yes, beta.
Hello. One of my friend is unable to join, sir. Hello.
Okay.
So.
Yes.
Sir, put it to admit all, sir.
Admit all only it is, because of the network, I think it will take time. Okay, he has joined. Very well. Okay. So now you can see. Yes. I'm going to take only first one. I'll take f of x is equal to s plus a. Is it clear? So now what will be f dash of s, because s is our parameter. So what will be f of f dash of s? Just a minute. Okay. So I have taken this f of x as s as s plus a. So what will be f dash of s? So derivative of f of s or differentiation of s plus a with respect to s is, differentiation of s is 1 plus differentiation of a is 0. So this is equal to 1. Means we have the formula, that is f dash of s divided by f of s will be equal to log of f of s. So in the beginning I have given the formula, right? This first formula I'm going to use. Okay, Now I will simplify. So this integration f dash of s is 1, so I will take 1 divided by f of s is s plus a. Is it clear? So this will become, can anybody tell me what will be this equal to?
So log s plus a.
Yes, very good. You understood. Log s plus a is a correct answer. Okay. Similarly, immediately you can see integration 1 upon s plus b is there. Can anybody tell me what will be the answer?
Log s plus b.
Yes, very good. So this is log s plus b. So now I will use this integration for 1 upon s plus a and minus 1 upon s plus b. So what will be the integration, students? It is going to become log of s plus a minus log of s plus b in the interval s to infinity. Everyone understood? So I have used these two formulas. Yes, by knowing this. So what I have told you, remember yes, the formula, second and third formula, you can identify very easily and apply to that. Keep that trick in your mind. So this is our general formula. So please note down this, very, very important. This is general formula. By using this formula, one can easily get next two formulas. So you can see, you will get the direct answer. Okay, now I have to substitute one by one. I will use the property, logarithmic property, students. You know already, that is log of a minus log of b will be equal to log of a divided by b. So this property I will use. So this will become log of s plus a, right, divided by s plus b. Understood how to simplify this? So which property have used? This property have used here. Log of a minus log of b is equal to log of a divided by b. So here it is log of s plus a minus log of s plus b will become log of s plus a divided by s plus b in the interval s to infinity. So because this is infinity, I cannot use this directly, students, please remember. So what I have to do? Yes, so I will use another one trick, that this infinity I will take in terms of limit. So what we have here, limit as s is tending towards infinity for log s plus a divided by s plus b, and then minus we have log. I am going to substitute s is equal to infinity and s is equal to s only. So therefore this is log of s plus a divided by s plus b remains as it is because I have substituted s only. Now I think you know the integration of f of x dx. I think you know everyone, in the interval a to b, you can see this is f of b minus f of a, right? Everybody knows this basic formula.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Right? This formula I have used here. Okay. So therefore, this is going to become log, I will take it outside. So because I want to limit this function tends to infinity, s plus a divided by s plus b, I will keep it as it is. Okay, minus this value also I will keep it as it is. I don't want to change this value. Okay, so now, okay, now further you can see very easily that when, how I simplify this problems. I think you have come across, that is limit. In the diploma you have come across limit unit is there. So this is s plus a divided by s plus b. How we can simplify limit, what we say, method, limit method. Yes, so whenever division method they have given for the limit, what you do, you just take out s from numerator and common s from denominator. So what I will do here, students, I will take s from numerator and s from denominator. So what will be the equation? It will become limit as s tends to infinity. If I take s common from this, it will become 1 plus a upon s. Am I right? Because here s is not there. So if I want to take out s, I have to divide s. Similarly, this is 1 plus b upon s. Have you understood this, friends? In the numerator and denominator, I have taken s common. So when I take s common, here there will be no s in this. It will become 1. And here you can see in this, we don't have s. So I have to divide by s. Is it clear? So this step you have to remember whenever there is division. This is fixed. You are going to take whenever there it will be infinity, because here you can see in the formula they have mentioned here infinity. So we cannot use directly the infinity. This is the only method to find infinity. So you can see s and s will get cancelled. And now you can see I will substitute s is equal to infinity in this equation. So this will become 1 plus a upon infinity divided by 1 plus b upon infinity. So anything upon infinity, what is the value? Can anybody tell me?
Zero.
Yes, it is zero.
Zero, sir.
We use fourth formula. So means this is equal to 1 plus 0 divided by 1 plus 0, which is equal to 1. Yes, have you understood this, friends? Okay, this I will apply here. So therefore, this will become log. This full equation will become now 1. So this is log 1 minus log s plus a divided by s plus b will remain. Okay, now you can see what is log 1. Can anybody tell me what is log 1, students?
Zero.
Yes. Zero. So third formula I'm going to use, log 1 is 0. Okay. So therefore this is 0. I want to take minus inside. So what I will do? I will reverse this. So you can see this will become plus log. Numerator will become denominator and denominator will become numerator when I take minus inside. I think you know we have come across the property that is log of a raised to p, right? So you can see this will become log of on a raised to minus p. So this is what we have the property. So using this property, one can easily take this log s plus b divided by s plus a. So therefore Laplace transform of e raised to minus a t plus minus e raised to minus b t divided by t is equal to, we have calculated this as log s plus b divided by s plus a. So this is our answer. Please, friends, in the exam also you write down here answer and mark this as in the box. Is it clear? So you can see here I have used very simple steps. Only thing, the side formulas you have to note it down very well and you have to practice once again. Is it clear, students? Any doubt?
Excuse me, sir.
Yes, beta. Yes, tell me your question.
So this problem, how many marks exam?
Yes, these are all 5 marks problems. Huh? Please note down, very, very important.
Only and 5, sir?
Only you will get. Yes, you can see within 15 minutes, one can easily solve. So 15 minutes, 5 marks.
Only 5, sir?
Beta. So it, not more steps, these are. See, 1, 2, 3. This is again same step I have repeated. So this is 4, right? This is simplification, and this is 5, last step.
Okay, sir.
Okay, beta. So let us now try the next example. See, those who have understood and they are perfect, they think that we can solve the next problem. Please try the next problem. And those who are still having some doubt, look at this example. I will solve for them. Okay, so please try the next example.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes, beta.
Sir, doubt in last step, sir. So this, how the minus sign got converted into plus?
Okay, see here. I think you have come across this is P log A will become log A raised to P, right?
Yes, sir.
What I have done? Minus log S plus A divided by S plus B. This was remaining here, right? So what I have done, I have taken minus on this side, so this will become log S plus A divided by S plus B raised to minus 1. So when you reverse this, what will happen? This is equal to log 1 upon S plus A divided by S plus B. Am I right? So it will go to the denominator. So further, if you simplify, you can easily take out S plus A in the numerator. So this will become log S plus A divided by S plus B divided by S plus A. Is it clear?
Okay, sir.
Okay, thank you. So let us solve the next problem. Let us see how many will get the correct answer. So just they have told you Laplace transform. Very simple question. Laplace transform of this. Find the Laplace transform. Finish. So what you will do? You will start solving the solution. So let us see how many students can solve this very easily. As I have told you, first take Laplace transform. See, first step everybody can write down. That is Laplace transform of cos 2t minus cos 3t divided by t. Okay, till here everybody can do. And using the property, what the property says, you can see here, this t will go, divided by t will go, it will become integration. Integration f of s means this, you are going to write this as L of f of t. Is it clear? So here I will use this property. Okay, therefore this will become, very easily you can see, one can easily write this integration s to infinity, and this will become Laplace of cos 2t minus cos 3t and ds. I think this first step is easy, right? Everybody understood first step?
Yes, sir.
Yes, okay. Now you can see which formula I have to use. I have to think. That is Laplace of cos 3t formula you have to remember. Can anybody tell me what is the formula of cos 18?
S by S square plus square plus A square.
Yes, S upon S square plus A square. See, one formula you remember. Then you now compare this and this equation. You can easily find A is 2. Right? So therefore, L of cos 2t will become S upon S square plus 2 square. Or you can easily write this as S upon S square plus 4. Is it clear? Next. Okay. Now you can see very easily. The next one you can do now. What is that? This cos. I will compare this equation again. You can see here it is A is equal to 3 is given. So Laplace transform of cos 3t is equal to S upon S square plus 3 square will become 9. So therefore, I will simplify this all values. So integration of S to infinity, I can see very easily. So cos of 2t will become S divided by S square plus 4. Am I right? Then next minus cos 3t, it is going to become s upon s square plus 9, finish. So keep this in your mind. First step, keep in your mind. You have to do like this in this form. Next step, what we have? Compare this equation, see. Next step, it must be in terms of log. Keep this in your mind, students. I'm going to tell you the direct formula, direct value you can see in. Integration of f dash s upon f of s, it will be in this form only. Otherwise, you have to make the corrections. Okay, so let us use this formula, that is integration f dash s upon f of s is equal to log s. Please remember this, you have to use in the division rule, division by t. Now you can see in this, I will take f of s as s square plus 4, am I right? Okay, so immediately I have to go for f dash of s. F dash of s is what? Can anybody tell me the quick answer?
2s.
2s, that's it. Because plus 4 will become 0. So means in the numerator 2 is missing, am I right? So you can see it must be f dash of s, exactly the derivative must be there in the numerator. So in the numerator only s is there, 2 is missing. So I have to think now, I want here 2. So what I will do in the next step, you can see I will multiply and divide by 2. So therefore integration s to infinity, I will make this trick, see, I will make this 2s. So if I want 2 in the numerator, definitely I should have in the new denominator 2, right? So okay, similarly you can see here, same way f of s, I will take here f of s, what I will do, I will choose s square plus 9. Immediately you can see f dash of s, you have to calculate it is 2s. Here also 2 is missing, so means I will multiply by 2 and divide by 2. Is it clear? So it will become f dash of s divided by f of s. Is it clear? F dash of s divided by f of s is clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Now you can see I am going to take log. So therefore this will be quite easy. So you can see this 1 upon 2 is there. I will take it outside. Here also 1 upon 2 is there. It is common. So I will take out 1 upon 2 and I will implement the integration. So what will be log? Log s square plus 4 minus log s square plus 9 in the interval s to infinity. Is it clear, students?
Yes, sir.
Yes, because this is integration f dash of s divided by f of s. Immediately you should remember this formula, that it is f of s. Okay, now same step, see, they are all same steps. This is equal to, I will keep 1 upon 2 as it is, use the property as we have used in this property, that is log of a minus log of b is equal to log of a divided by b. See, same steps. So this will become log of s square plus 4 divided by s square plus 9. So these are all same steps, you can see, only numbers are changed. Now again, one can easily find without simplifying, students. You can write it directly. So 1 upon 2. Okay. So you can see when I substitute s as infinity. Yes, please remember, when I substitute s is equal to infinity, can anybody tell me what will be the log of s square plus 4 divided by s square plus 9? What is the value? See, student, this is the trick you have to understand. Very easily I will tell you. See, when I have taken log of s plus a divided by s plus b as s tending to infinity, what was the answer? What was the answer?
Zero.
Zero means, what is means? Now if I take s tending towards infinity, what will be this answer?
Zero.
Very good. That's the simple. See, very, very important. Keep this in your mind. It is going to become zero minus. Now I will substitute s is equal to s itself. Therefore, this is minus log of s square plus 4 divided by s square plus 9. Is it clear? When I substitute s is equal to infinity, it is 0, and s is equal to s, I have substituted it, then it will become log of s square plus 4 divided by s square plus 9. Is it clear? So, okay, now I will simplify. I will write it in terms of like this. So, minus, I will take 1 upon 2 inside this bracket. So, you can see this will become minus 1 upon 2. Log of next is just simplification, or you can keep this as it is, but if possible you can simplify again, use the formula, that is I will take this 1 upon minus 1 upon 2 as the power, yes, using the log of s square plus 4 divided by s square plus 9 raised to minus 1 upon 2. Is it clear? So how I can simplify this again? You can also simplify. You can keep this as answer, no problem. Okay, so this is going to become log of 1 divided by s square plus 4 divided by s square plus 9 raised to 1 upon 2. So you can see minus will become plus. Am I right? This will go to the numerator. Denominator of denominator will go to numerator, and one can easily find root 2. Suppose if you take root 2, it is nothing but 2 raised to 1 upon 2. So means if you take any value, raised to 1 upon 2 will become square root s square plus 9 divided by s square plus 4. So this is our answer, students. Any doubt, please ask me. Yes, students, any doubt, please ask me.
Sir, that...